thanks for tuning in to the Bob Anthony Show. I'm your host, Bob Anthony. Today we have another fantastic show for you with some film clips from some friends of ours who've been to our studios years ago, who've now made their inroads into Hollywood. These are kickboxers, karate, so any of you channel surfers out there who just tuned into us, our show is show business. So today's guests are going to tell you a little bit about their struggles and their success of getting their first film in the can and their next project that's going to soon be coming up that they're going to be looking out there for not only the investors, but you people who want to get in the behind scenes to help them make their next film. So stand by and we'll be with you in a moment. Today, we, like we said, is Dominic LaBanca, our friend Dominic.
Hey,
Dominic, I'm glad to have you aboard.
Thanks.
And on my left here, we have David Tanner. David, thanks for coming in, taking your time to let our community of viewers out there learn a little bit about how to get in the movies. So we'll go to Dominic before we show a little bit of his film clip. I understand Roger Corman's people got you started after you took out some videotapes and things that we helped you prepare earlier in your career. What was it, 1992? You were
92,
getting organized?
Right. It was 92 when I met you, of course, and that's when I really had my main interest in getting into the film industry. My main assets were the martial arts. I started training when I was 10. I've been training now for 15 years, along with the help of my coach, Dave, and also
right.
a friend.
By the way, what's the name of the film there?
The film is Dragonfire.
Dragonfire. We'll have a clip of that in a minute. So, did he train long with you? I understood you guys used to train late into the night.
Yeah, about 2 years
you were
we trained.
Obsessed with,
yeah.
What are you? You were a master in the Philippine arts of karate. What is all that about?
I was given certification to create my own system. I am a master teacher as far as my certification gives me that title. But really what I focus on is kickboxing and American martial arts. I incorporate the Filipino striking methods.
Well, I think you've accomplished a lot of it. Let's go to that film clip and we'll come back to you two guys and discuss it further. Fight scenes and all of that action was done very, very convincingly. A lot of people think that they've got to go to extensive acting lessons. In some cases, people need that. But in a lot of cases, you go out there and it's meeting contacts. Wouldn't you say so, like you did? Like yourself,
yeah.
You went out there and it was a personality. It was
right.
Meeting people,
exactly.
Contacts, a little piece of tape. You have a little resume that's necessary when it's necessary. So do you agree the same thing, that it's not necessarily taking a lot of lessons and going to all kinds of speech classes or changing your personality? Let people meet you as you are and go from there.
A lot of times you have to meet the right people. It's basically looking for people like us who really want to do something in the film business, but have had a hard time maybe breaking in. So we want to give people a chance.
You're familiar with NYU, the people out there.
Right.
I understand
you've got a lot of people there, right?
Right. I've met George Stoney out there, and he's trying to help us, too. He's one of the board directors on Manhattan Neighborhood Network.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a good group of people at NYU, at Rutgers University. There's some friends of ours out there, and also out here in Columbia, the screenwriters and so forth. So who knows? You people come around into this environment, you're bound to meet some good people. So, Dominic, let's go back to you.
Yeah, I believe your acting lessons are through meeting people.
Right.
Learning how
life is an act, actually.
Life is, well, acting is real, is an act of reality.
Mm-hmm.
See, what we're trying to do here, like Dave says, we want to bring people who didn't get a chance. We want to bring real people out there. Okay.
Right.
It's nice to use named actors and everything, but we want to do something different because I've trained in martial arts so long and I believe that my style is unique to the thanks to my teacher Dave here, who really opened
up
the martial arts.
All right, let's go to Dave for a minute. And Dave.
The same. So, just do this. No, you gotta go like this one. All right, okay, now do the disarm slowly. You're good. Good facial expression. Good facial expression. Bring the stick back for a good facial expression.
Right, you've been around it, I understand. In fact, I think you brought in a couple of your programs you did a while back, and you paid your dues.
Right.
I heard it was on the cable program recently. What was it on?
Cinemax.
Cinemax?
Cinemax, yeah.
How was it to get him, to convince him that he better go slow at it? He was very, very lucky, as I'm sure you'll agree.
Oh, definitely. I traveled all the way to the other side of the world to start a film project in Indonesia. And since then, I started four other projects. All of them fell through. And
in what sense did they fall through? You were, what, production, making film, or?
It's just maintaining control over the film, the way I wanted it to be shot, and credentials and all that kind of stuff.
What do you basically look forward to getting going here? Your script is in what situation now? Is it in a treatment form? Or?
Yeah, we have a treatment. I actually want to stick with you, Bob, because...
Well, great. I'll do everything we can. We know some nice people out there. I'd like to get the clip of this film Dominic did in front of Fred Caruso, who's getting ready for a film with the director did The Fugitive. I think they got Tommy Lee Jones lined up, and Fred Caruso was at the beginning a production manager. He's done Blue Velvet, he's doing many other films, and he's now getting ready for a big project out in Santa Barbara. I think they're doing something. He's always advised me for people like you to say, bring their things to his attention, and a little film clip like this tells these professionals whether they want to help you get into some distribution context and, you know, start off wherever you're starting off from. But what you're doing right now, both of you, I think you're on the right track.
Hey, what is that? Hey,
crazy business. You just got to have the patience to get the right people.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it takes time, a lot of networking, getting to know people, be respectful, and you know, don't get anybody's bad side. Right.
This leading part, how did it all happen?
And a videotape.
Suggested to you, that helps the director.
They've also put a final edit on it and a fighting scene choreographed, which was the real key.
Well, you guys did a lot of preparation, right? A little piece of tape together and went to California and hit a home run. Show about show business, and we have filmmakers that come to us from NYU, Columbia. Today we have Dominic LaBanca, actor who got his first starring role in a Roger Corman film that was done by, who was the producer on that?
The producer was Mike Elliott.
Mike Elliott, yeah. And there was a good director.
Very talented director, Rick Jacobson.
Rick Jacobson, yeah. And the DP did a great job.
Mike Gallagher.
Right. Yeah. It was a beautiful film. You did quite a job on it. Even though there's a big audience for that overseas and all, I understand it's doing pretty good in the video stores now and it's giving you a launching pad.
It's not doing too bad.
Right. You know. And these little clips, we hope some of our viewers out there that are watching, that are interested in Dominic LaBanca for considering their next script to get in touch with us. Our phone number is constantly shown on the screen here, and we have our other guest with us, Dave Tanner, who's Dominic's close friend and trainer, and they're getting ready for another project, and you're going to be needing help, I'm sure. Besides investors, you're looking also for crew and backup people, right. And here at Manhattan Neighborhood Network, you've already, just by coming up here, bumped into filmmakers and people who already want to get started with you guys, because it's a long road. And we're going to close off with our friends here doing a little demonstration, since they are kickboxers and martial artists, and Dave Tanner, the coach for Dominic LaBanca, who helped prepare him to get his break out in Hollywood. And we were also happy to help Dominic put together his videotape and how to organize himself. So anybody out there that's interested in this type of work and being in the show business, either in front of the camera or behind it, be sure to get in touch with us. We'll see if we can help you in any way we can. Again, thanks for tuning in and sending your letters to us, and those phone calls are really appreciated.
Hey, Bob.
Especially the positive comment. Good luck to you, Dominic.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay, and thanks for coming
on. Thank you, Bob.
Okay.
It's been fun.
Let's see that center here.
Thanks, man.
Hey.
Take a look at that.
Let's see that fold out.
Okay, so hold this up.
Hey, Dominic, I'm really proud of you. You really did it. Oh, great. This is a shot that almost looks like the one we shot in the studio that got you out to Hollywood. Are we getting this?
This is great. I didn't expect
got
this.
Got it? Okay, good luck, you guys. So show them what you're doing. We'll be standing over here.
You got this?